वेलकम ऑल। सो वी आर एट द स्ट्रैटेजिक प्रोजेक्ट विच इज नोन एज ब्लॉकचेन मैच्योरिटी मॉडल। सो आई एम मेपन ओवर हियर विद माय पर्सनल इंटरेस्ट। आई एम हैंडलिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्किंग ग्रुप स्टैंडर्ड्स एंड सर्टिफिकेशंस अपॉर्चुनिटी गिवन बाय मिस्टर जराड। एंड एनी इंट्रोडक्शंस यू कैन पुट इट इन द चैट बॉक्स। दिस इज गोइंग टू बी अ 15 मिनट्स प्रेजेंटेशन and after that we'll have a 15 minutes question and discussion session. You can always post your questions at any point of time, not a problem at all. In case of any disconnections, of course we'll resume by 3 minutes max. Emergency will be Mr. Robert or Mr. Gerard. Okay, so this is where we are. Yes, so standards and certification working group focus. So the focus of this particular group as such is to ensure quality, accountability, reliability, and sustainability of blockchain solutions. And this group is going to develop some risk-based standards for the establishment, implementation, maintenance, and continual improvement of blockchain solutions. So these standards can be used for assessment, evaluation of the products, processes, organization to support the acquisition of the management or source of selection. That is basically whenever an organization wants to select an application, so they can always rely on these kind of standards if they are implemented, and that is what the intention is. And of course, we are here to explore and experiment with a new type of concept, DAO, for establishment, maintenance, and assessment, including the compliance of the requirements of this particular models or any standard which we are creating out. So this is a experimental project which we are planning, and which would be the final goal of this particular standards certification working group. And what is the project? The strategic project goals are there, where we are having standardization by a blockchain maturity model. So blockchain maturity model itself, the name holds its understanding. It is for assuring and ensuring the accountability, quality, reliability, sustainability of the blockchain solution. And further down, we are going to establish some kind of requirements and expectations, basically, for any kind of solution. And then we are going to establish some criteria to assess the maturity. Then we will have a few criteria for training and qualifying individual assessors. The whole project goal is to provide the confidence to the government and private sectors using the blockchain technology in achieving their goals. So that is the whole intention. Basically, we are here to give a confidence by placing this project upfront and trying to bring out a maturity model. Okay, so the basic questions are there. Why a standardization is required? So basically, everyone knows that, but even then we need to speak something on the terms of blockchain. So we have some few ideas here. Create a standardized way to maintain common thought process. Globally provide the same language to make everyone understand blockchain. Equal trust on the process that creates the blockchain solution. So that is basically, that is where a layman or a technical person should understand with the trust. And creating a confidence on the blockchain solution used by an individual or organization. So either by a government or a non-government organization. Creating confidence is something like, that is a way of approach of assessment also, or auditing. And decentralized information consolidation. So basically, the whole concept of standardization lies as a decentralized mode. So that is where they're trying to bring it as a blockchain based standardization. The new technology having multiple features for the various applications, hence standardization required for sustainable usage. So this concept is very simple. In a blockchain technology, you have multiple type of informations which has to be covered and to be ensured and to be followed also. So all those things are to be brought into a single sustainable usage. So that is why standardization is required. So with that, we are moving forward for why assessment is required. So basically, to understand the status of the blockchain solution, to keep benchmark with the standardized requirements, collective assessment by assessors to ensure the requirements are taken to the next level. So this is basically whenever we have an assessment, so the interest is not to be on the same level, so to go ahead or to showcase to the society to what level that particular solution can make its level would be the basic assessment method. Then understanding the maturity of each application on each domain. So domain specific also may be a possibility, wherein apart from a generic way of approach, we may also go into a domain specific approach and try to understand the maturity. Provide the end user the confidence of the maturity level by decentralized assessment. So basically the interest is on the whole, we would like to have it as a decentralized assessment, not to have a centralized assessment sort of thing. Of course, our experimental project is there where we are going to create a DAO covering EIMCA. So will be a point where it's going to showcase that the decisions are taken based on the available parameters on that particular solution. So coming to the blockchain maturity model, of course, there is a R&E, that is requirement and expectations. Of course, these requirements are basically planned or collected with the discussions and decisions are doing a brainstorming as a risk-based approach. So the whole risk-based approach is meant for assisting the blockchain application development. So it can be for a startup or it can be an existing project which is rolling out. So where they can always look into what would be the best practice which can be taken up from this model and ensured for implementation. So based on the requirements, on the expectations, each element of the blockchain application can be demonstrated for its maturity. So there is the concept of the blockchain maturity model is bifurcated into elements. So where each element needs to be demonstrated for its maturity. Proactively classify the application on level wise. So we are going to classify each and every application on a level based approach. So where level one, level two, level three, level four are there, which are being defined. So the whole intention of this particular R&D is to give a confidence, of course, confidence of for transacting in a blockchain application. And in fact, this is done for the society and to have a good trust for the development which has been delivered to the usage. Of course, we have a good number of teams. Our working group team are consisting of 27 members. We have very good number of people and we have a link over here. Please, any GBA members who have not joined can always join this group to contribute themselves. So this is our group presently, which is available. And this is the BMM architecture, which is a high level architecture in nature. Of course, this, If you are becoming a working group member, you will be available to access these documents, informations, and understand more and more. Of course, we have something more down. So I would like to go to the specific levels. So BMM requirements and expectations architecture is this. So wherein it is going to have a generic element and a domain-specific technical areas. So from where we are going into the BMM requirements and expectations, generic elements are about 10 which have been disclosed and drafted so far. Governance, identity and access management, immutability, node ubiquity, performance, privacy, resilience, security, reliability, and sustainability. So these are the 10 elements which has been drafted and almost we can say it is freezed, but still we have time to confirm those statuses. And with this, when we go into the domain specific technical requirement, of course, domain specific technical requirements again goes into government and non-government. Of course, in government, we have one of the election app system standard, which is being managed by the voting system, voting standard groups. So we expect something to be completed soon. And that will be taking over on the technical requirement architecture as one of the type, so one of the domain as such. And in fact, this will be above the generic requirements which we hold. So that is what is the expectation, what we have planned, and hope it should be been done on that pattern. So coming into each element will have level one, level two, level three, level four, level five, and level one would be the feasible, level two functional, level 3 operational, level 4 scalable, and level 5 sustainable. So even though from top to down it is on the reverse hierarchy, so you have to go by initially will be on the 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 would be the toppest rating of level, and the reachability depends upon each project as such. And in fact, we are having something like enterprises level deployment and global level deployment. Of course, enterprises level deployment also may come to the level of 5 according to their disclosures, or according to their according to the requirements being met or their expectation being demonstrated. So there are some good definitions for each levels. So according to these definitions, we are planning our elements as such. So each and every element is working on these kind of definitions, and based on this we are preparing the requirements and the expectations. So this is the BMM assessment architecture, where we have the assessment mode, where it is going to be an assessor requirement. GBA trainee assessor is there, GBA assessor would be developed, then GBA lead assessor would be developed. And assessing method will be a GBA lead assessor driven, which is basically a conventional method. And the other one, which is innovation, is going to be on GBA DAO, that is a DAO driven assessment method. So which is also a part of this particular DAO project. So hope to reach this particular area soon. And deliverables of the strategic project BMM and opportunity beneficiaries are something like BMM requirements and expectations are one of the deliverable, which is a proactive risk approach based BMM. And then the assessment requirements will come inside, where it's going to be on strength of elements methodology. So the name itself defines its meaning. So it is going to check out on each element's strength. So how well we are able to provide it. So that would be one. Am I on?
I can hear you.
Yes. Okay, great. So BMM assessors requirements would be one of the deliverables. And then we'll be having the BMM lead assessor requirements. Then we'll be having some BMM badges. So badges would be a part of providing an identity or a self-sovereign identity for each of the assessor or the lead assessor, and also the qualified applications as such. So the society is going to be a beneficiary. So where user gets the confidence and the organization gets credibility for being developing these kind of applications. And individuals are going to get recognized as assessors with their qualifications. Even node owners may be there, where we will be taking some kind of help from GBBP and creating some nodes for these kind of assessments. These are all long-term goals. Of course, we expect everyone should be taking some kind of benefit from getting this particular blockchain maturity model, and it's a win-win situation. So contribution by members, of course, we have conducted around 13 working group meetings completed, and top contributors are Mr. Gerard, Dino, Paul, Rose, Allison, Will, Frederick, and so on. So of course, plenty of persons are there coming in and out, but everyone are there to give a contribution. And elements have been drafted, 10 we have confirmed, and we are going on that. Terms and definitions are in draft stage. BM expectations by level 5, 1 to 5, with the, which is nothing but the criteria for meeting, for developing an application, is in draft stage. Assessment requirements are getting drafted, which is being, we can say that it started. Of course, we are yet to develop any assessor requirements so far, so we are just in progress. The overall BMM go live target is September 2021, so which we are targeting, and we are working hard on that. Hopefully, we have to complete it before September 2021. So for any public non-GBA or working group members, please access these links. During the discussion time, I'll be posting these links in the chat box. You can always pick them from there and use it. So if you're not a member, you can become a member. And if you're already a member, you can always participate through the link, which is for standards. So if you come through this link, if you're a member, you can always access our group and give some contributions on the BMM. Voting criteria, of course, we have two different voting criteria over here. One is draft, other one is for final, and for draft, it's within the working group. So the basic idea of this particular voting is more than the criteria, there is a requirement which is highlighted over here. Any oppositions on the 80% needs to be considered. So even one member is going to oppose on the requirement, of course, we will consider that and we will try to justify or get justified. And then comes the final voting criteria. Final voting criteria is going to be among all other working groups. So where we are going to circulate the draft, circling draft and getting finalized on those things. And of course, there it is going to be 70%, and any oppositions on the 70% also will be considered. So that is what our principle of calculation is giving. In fact, we have always a requirement for change. So if anything is there, we will surely revisit and revise the particular calculation methodology. It's not a big issue. Moving forward, public meeting every month we are conducting. So every month, first Thursday is meant for the public. We expect any public to participate in that particular meeting. The timing is 11 to 12 of EST, and wherein we expect more contributions from the public. And GBA Standards and Certification Working Group members meetings are planned on every Thursdays at 11 to 12. Of course, I take an opportunity to thank all the Standards and Certification Working Group members, and particularly Mr. Gerard, for giving me this particular opportunity. And I hope I have been within the time a little bit more, I think. Okay, so we have now the time for discussion. So I leave the floor to the participants. So any questions, any requirements, I'm there for the call. I'll stop the share now.
Lewis has got a question. Lewis, you want to go ahead and ask it?
Hey, good afternoon, guys. I'm actually thinking, because I've been asked this before, if GBA actually offers like a badge or gives some type of certification with the blockchain, because I've seen other institutions or other people that give per se a certificate that has a QR code that links to a blockchain where they could certify this badge. So I was just wondering if there's any pilots or anything in place or people speaking about this use case.
Ross and Teresi, do you want to address that?
I'll address it. The answer is yes. We expect to have that in the next month and a half or so.
In fact, in the presentation, we have projected that we are going to give some badges that will be a part of the project.
Yeah, one of the GBA members votes, VOATZ. We're hoping that we can finish the BMM and the voting working group standards sometime soon and potentially get votes a GBA certification. It's sort of a chicken and an egg thing, because we're using votes as an example of an implementation of a project that could be certified. But then again, the certification teams or the standards teams are defining criteria that may be above where they currently are now. So then votes would have to essentially adjust their implementation to meet the standards. So if we can align basically what the community believes is a minimum acceptable standards, and votes can meet that standard, then that works as a positive thing for both of us. And hopefully that might be one of the first systems that GBA certifies, but we've got a lot of work to do between now and then. Mark Montoya, you got a comment?
Yes, I got a comment. A great presentation, my opinion. I really like it. Really like what's going on with what you guys are doing in the group. So I have a question. So I understand that this model is sort of a framework, but is there any chance in the future to instantiate this model into some type of exchangeable format like XML or XBRL, so it can be interoperable with other models?
Interoperable with other models, it's a difficult question, because we are going to be unique. That's first point. So that's what I think. I can be corrected by Mr. Gerard if I'm wrong. So Gerard, you would like to share some thoughts? I think we are going to be unique, right? So this model is going to be unique.
Of course. In my opinion, you're never wrong. But I'm wondering if Mark Montoya could explain, because the concept, so I've got a background in standards and certifications as well, and the concept of interoperable models, I'm not that familiar with it, Mark, so I'm wondering, could you kind of explain what that is, and then also maybe share a little bit about the event that we're going to do in August?
Oh, yeah, sure. So the idea behind this, again, I understand the model we have here is kind of like a framework. We're coming up with the elements and, you know, those I don't know what they're, I think they're 10 elements right now. But the idea behind this, right, and interoperability is instantiated into some type of machine readable format, like, again, like XML, like XBRL, it can be FixML, it can be another standard format that can be exchanged from a computer that we have here to another computer, right? And being able to have this model be tied into other models out there, like the NEAM format for cybersecurity, for DoD format, for I forgot what they use from their standpoint of defining certain terminology and using it for backend systems. So the idea of having this and then having the blockchain and distributed ledger technology, you have the payload, you have the data and you have the payload that gets exchanges from machine to machine. So the idea is instantiating this into some type of, you can say schema file, XML file, that can be used with other systems, not just in and of the people that actually use the, or get certified from GBA standpoint on the blockchains that are out there, but being able to be exchanged with other formats. And that's where it comes interoperability, because these standards are still new and they're gonna change, right? You know, they're eventually gonna change. They may stay the same, but there's gonna be something new coming down the road. And to be able to have this model be extensible too, not just concrete, but extensible.
Let me pause you for a second. This is exactly what I was hoping we could get out of this event. So, Mayapin, let's talk with Mark afterwards. I'd like to have for consideration in our strategic plan, figuring out how we can do interoperability. Right. And because what we are doing is we're going to be meeting with folks from the ISO technical committees and other things. We definitely want to harmonize. And if interoperability is something that would make this thing better, let's at least talk about it. I think I have a faint idea of what Mark's talking about. But I think, Mark, if you and Mayapin could have a follow-up conversations and maybe give us some advice and guidance about potentially how to do that, then that could demonstrate leadership in the standards world, because, you know, I don't know how ISO and some of these other organizations, and do we have Frederick, you know, Frederick, it would be interesting to involve you and ACT IAC in that conversation, because how cool would it be for us to be able to deploy a framework that really, and as I've been told, is way out in front of everybody else, but to make it in such a way that it benefits all of the other standards organizations that would demonstrate real leadership on our part. So Mark, thank you so much for bringing that up. I think it's an excellent point.
Yeah. But, and Gerard, I'm sorry, let me go on to the August 5th. What is it, August 5th? Yeah, the standards roundtable that we're gonna have, Mayapin and yes. The other organizations, ISO is gonna be there. And I think there's another group that's involved. I think, Frederick's actually speaking. But this is going to be happening between 11 and 1 Eastern Daylight Time. it's just essentially a collaboration, an open discussion to talk about how we can actually collaborate going forward on the initiatives that we're actually doing. And I think this is a great start that we have here with GBA, what Mayapin and the group's done.
Yeah. In fact, there is one particular interoperability which we are thinking about is we are syncing few of the terminologies with respect to the ISO. So wherein when an organization is going to take up to the level 3, so automatically that basically ISO focuses on the organization level, but we are going to focus on the application level. And if they are level 3, that particular application should be equal or meeting the requirements of ISO standard. So that is one of the expectations what we have in parallel. So wherein the initiations what are happening is we are absolutely trying to match with ISO standard terminologies. definitions. So these kind of things are already in progress. So of course, this particular discussions gives more insight wherein we need to be interoperable with the other particular standards.
Yeah, they're a great team. You know, David Hartridge, Allison Ugardi, they all know the and Frederick. I mean, you have a great team out there that's gonna get it to the end. It's awesome. Good work.
And Mark, there's a concept in CMMI called equivalent staging, and just like Maya can said, what we'd like to do is, you know, if we're using the same vocabulary that ISO is and stuff like that, you know, being in that space and seeing how companies have had to struggle with different standards, and one contract might require standard A and another contract might require standard B, and companies have to go through incredible efforts to satisfy both standards, two separate assessors. But if we can create something called equivalent staging, meaning if you satisfy all the requirements of all level three, then you automatically qualify for ISO, then we can start working with those organizations and see if we can cross-train, you know, cross-qualify assessors and training materials and really bring the cost of credentialing down for many of these organizations.